Back in the early 70s, American economist Milton Friedman proclaimed that there is one and only one social responsibility of business: to use its resources and engage in activities designed to increase its profits. To most people, this idea sounds nothing short of a formulaic rapper's Scrooge McDuck billionaire fantasy music video. Obviously, this idea is ridiculous. Or is it? In this video, we will go over the case for profit maximization, discuss some possible shortcomings that lead to the idea of corporate social responsibility, and attempt to make a reasonable conclusion regarding the subject. Friedman's idea of profit maximization is slightly more nuanced than it seemed in the opening quote. The quote ends with the phrase, "to increase its profits so long as it stays within the rules of the game, which is to say engages in open and free competition without deception or fraud." Furthermore, Friedman claimed that businesses should abide by the basic social norms of society, and that this doesn't necessarily just mean increasing short-term profits at the expense of long-term profits. The profit-maximizing school of thought would claim that corporate executives are agents of the business owners or shareholders and have the obligation to maximize profit, which is what the shareholders want. Okay, poor rich people, you're probably thinking, but the case for profit maximization goes beyond respecting the desires of shareholders. Theoretically, in a sufficiently competitive market, firms produce goods and services to meet the needs of society. Consumers voluntarily buy products, and obviously only do so if it makes them better off by at least a price. Firms buy the things they need for production and are therefore paying the cost of producing their goods, so it means that the things they buy are worth it to society. Profit can be thought of as a net contribution to society, so firms are obligated to maximize it. Okay, so you think the world would just be better off if firms always maximize profits? Well, not exactly. As you might imagine, there are some flaws with such a line of thinking. First of all, this only works under the assumption of sufficient competition. When monopolies maximize profit, it does not lead to maximized prosperity for the world. More generally, as Kenneth Arrow points out, profit maximization fails to maximize prosperity in the presence of uncorrected externalities. What the heck is an externality? An externality is a cost or benefit of an economic transaction that is felt by people not involved in the transaction. The textbook example of a negative externality, meaning there's an external cost, is pollution. A firm may pollute to the point of maximizing profit, but the pollution obviously has a cost on society that the firm does not pay or really take into consideration. It's the same story for utility maximizing agents, like presumably you. Like, do you really take global warming into consideration when deciding whether it's worth it to drive to a Taylor Swift concert or something? Ultimately, this leads to an overconsumption of polluting goods relative to what would be socially optimal. Arrow also mentions information asymmetry as a situation in which profit maximization wouldn't be optimal for society. At this point, it's worth mentioning the difference between shareholder and stakeholder theory. Shareholder theory is essentially Friedman's view that the duty of a corporation is to increase profits for shareholders. Stakeholder theory, on the other hand, which is confusingly supported by Professor R. Edward Friedman, says that corporations should take all stakeholders like shareholders, employees, communities, and suppliers into consideration when making decisions. The ideas of stakeholder theory lead more generally to the idea of corporate social responsibility, or CSR. CSR is a fairly broad model that holds a company socially accountable. Engaging in CSR means that the company is enhancing society and the environment rather than negatively affecting them. Things that might count as CSR include environmentally sustainable supply chains, investing in local communities, and treating employees well. The number of businesses publishing CSR reports has risen substantially in the past few decades. In fact, the St. Louis Federal Reserve reports that from 2005 to 2008, the percentage of top 100 US companies publishing annual CSR reports increased from 37 to 74%. 80% of the world's largest 250 companies issued CSR reports in 2008. Before around the 20th century, CSR wasn't much of an issue because companies were generally just owned by individuals or small groups actively involved in management. However, in the 20th century, courts generally stated that corporations should increase profits for shareholders, though over time they gave a lot of discretion to managers to determine what is best for long-term profits and also allowed discretion regarding corporate responsibility. Many people who support CSR, including those websites that are like 12 empowering reasons why your business should practice CSR must read not clickbait 2019, claim that it can lead to increased long-term profitability. CSR can be a form of advertising. Happy employees are more productive and well-functioning communities can spend more money on your product. Even Milton Friedman claimed that actions that increase long-term profits and happen to produce good outcomes are permissible. Friedman claims that Friedman would be a stakeholder theorist today, even though he's dead and cannot confirm that sentiment, because that's how businesses increase profits. Friedman also claims that he's against businesses pursuing social good that doesn't have anything to do with business. The St. Louis Fed claims that modern theoretical and empirical analyses indicate that firms can strategically engage in socially responsible activities to increase private profits. So there it is. We can have the best of both worlds when firms maximize profits and produce social goods along the way. But that's not an entirely satisfying answer to the idea of corporate social responsibility. Like, who would argue against doing social good when it maximizes profits for shareholders? Here's a more difficult question. Is it ethical for a firm to do something that most people would consider to be a social good that would almost certainly decrease profits for investors? For example, if a firm has analytically determined that using green energy over fossil fuels will reduce profits, even taking into consideration the public goodwill it generates, should they choose green energy? Milton Friedman would probably say no, because the executive who is making that decision would be effectively taxing people, like the shareholders, consumers, or employees, and spending their money without their consent. Instead, one should try to institute a tax through a democratic process, and if that fails, you'd be going against the will of the majority. And at the end of the day, we all know Americans don't really give a about the environment. Surveys indicate that the vast majority of Americans are willing to incur very little personal cost for environmental reasons. So if choosing green energy would make consumer prices go up slightly, and it probably would because contrary to popular belief, the average company does not have a 36% profit margin, is Friedman right? Well, let me first start off by saying that I am not an economist, I am not a political scientist, I am not a philosopher, and I am not qualified to make any sort of definitive statement about the correct answer. However, most people who make these sorts of decisions in the real world, like me, have not spent years deliberating this exact question in an academically rigorous manner and may have to make a swift decision. So here are my hopefully informed but by no means conclusive thoughts on the matter. First of all, I think it would be helpful to split CSR into two parts: doing good and not doing harm. Doing good might be donating to a local school, whereas not doing harm might be disposing of waste properly instead of throwing it in a river. In terms of doing good, I think Milton Friedman has a bit of a point about spending other people's money on something completely unrelated to your business. A recent study found that firms that strategically implemented CSR after identifying what their customers, employees, and investors valued and integrated it into their profit-maximizing business model provided the most potential benefit to society. However, there are situations where a firm might donate to a completely unrelated cause, like a software consulting company in Seattle donating malaria nets to Africa. Buying malaria nets is certainly an effective and morally commendable thing to do, but the executive should donate his or her own money to the cause. Sure, stocks are generally owned by the wealthier echelon of Americans, but plenty of regular people rely on consistent returns for their retirements, and many pension funds rely on the type of returns that only are generated by equities. That's doing good. What about not doing bad? I think there are at least some situations where it is responsible to not maximize profits, specifically when it comes to lobbying and misinformation. Arrow mentions that information asymmetry is a situation in which pure profit maximization is not socially efficient. And I think that it would be socially responsible of companies to refrain from launching misinformation campaigns intended to conceal the harms of a product like cigarettes or even ExxonMobil's funding of climate change denial. What about the example from earlier regarding pollution? Let's just say that the firm has done the calculations and choosing the dirty option would create $1 million of extra profit but would damage society by $2 million. Should they do it? Friedman would say that the executive making the decision just hasn't convinced society that the cost of polluting is that high. But I think the problem with this reasoning is that it assumes everybody in the democracy shares the idea of what should be done in the case of an externality like that. Friedman's view would be legitimate, in my opinion, if everyone, or at least a majority, had a worldview that the type of person who reads The Economist would have. Specifically, that the free market is generally efficient and should be the main driver of economic activity in society, but there are also market failures and it's the government's job to come in and correct those market failures, hopefully through market-based and bureaucratically lean solutions like per unit taxes on externalities and some sort of net transfer like a negative income tax, which Friedman did support, as well as some reasonable public goods. However, it may very well be that the majority of people do want to reduce emissions but have too diverse of opinions to come to a consensus and get any legislation passed. Maybe some people think that the government is just incompetent and ruins everything it touches, or it doesn't have the right to interfere in the first place and that firms should voluntarily reduce emissions and profits. Maybe some people want regulations over taxes. Maybe some people don't believe in capitalism at all and will compromise at nothing short of beheading all billionaires. With political realities in mind, I think it would be morally commendable of a firm to not cause more negative externalities than they profit. But for example, if they could make $1 million and only cost society $500K, they should do that. But it's also, in my opinion, not necessarily morally required because of the tragedy of the commons and the fact that they might just get undercut by a competitor not doing the same sort of internal carbon pricing or whatever. In conclusion, should firms maximize profit? Yes, if it's a competitive market with limited externalities. I absolutely think a firm should contribute to social good when it maximizes profits. That's fairly uncontroversial. Everything isn't win-lose, and it's entirely reasonable that a company can benefit its bottom line and the community at the same time. However, I do not think publicly traded companies should donate to causes that have nothing to do with their business models beyond what generates public support. I think companies should refrain from misleading the public, and that it is morally commendable, but not morally required, to internally compensate for negative externalities. And if this video is bad, it's because YouTube's stupid watch time profit maximizing algorithm made me watch all of ABBA's music videos. Thank you for watching.